Hello and welcome back to ExpoHub channel. Today we are into exercise number 59 and let's understand what is the question you might get in your interview. Let's say the question is asked to you. There is a drop down, there is an application and there is a drop down and you have got multiple items, more than 100 items you have got. How will you select each item, right? Each item from the drop down one by one and do certain activity after that. So how will you select? First thing is you have to select one by one. First item, second item, third item, fourth item. So how this can be done? So this is a practical situation where generally in a project we have to go through such a drop down where I have to click and check certain things, then go to the second item, check certain things, then go to the third item, check certain things. So in such a case, how will you implement a solution to this? How will you select each and every item from the drop down? Okay, so the answer is quite simple. All you have to do is we can use a find children activity. So what is a find children activity? Find children activity, generally it will look if there is any other children inside a container element. For example, just imagine this is your container. Okay, so inside this container there are single elements are available, right? So these are called children's of the parent element. So each element are specific text. So each of these elements or the options are called the children's of the parent element. The parent element is nothing but the drop down box, right? So in such a case we can go for a find children activity. So let's see and quickly start designing it. So all I will do, I'll use a find children activity. Okay, now let us click on indicate on screen and indicate the drop down menu where it has got multiple children elements. Okay, so once I do this, all I will do, I'll create a variable in the output panel, control plus K, and let me name it as children's. Okay, so once you do it, one very important thing you need to understand, because this has got multiple items, this is kind of a enumerable variable, right? So if I go to variable panel, I'll be able to see enumerable UI element. So the type is UI element and it's an enumerable data type, right? It contains multiple data inside it like an array. Okay, so let's create a for each loop so that I can iterate through one item. Okay, so here in the for each loop, all I will do is in the type argument, go to browse for types and select UI element. UI, just type UI element. Okay, so it is part of uipath.core UI element. Simple. So now we have selected the UI element. All I will do is I'll put that variable, children's variable, which contains all the children items. Done. After that, what I can do is I'll use a get attribute activity. Okay, let's use a get attribute activity, and here the item, all the children are coming to this item, right? So what I will do in the get attribute element section, I'm going to type item. Simple. And then here I want the active accessibility name. So yesterday I told you about active accessibility name. This is nothing but the text that is being seen in the web page, active accessibility name. Okay, so I'm getting that. Once I get it, the output of that I want to store. Let's say I will say child. I'll create a variable called child, and inside this variable, child variable, this active accessibility name, for example, for the very first time when the loop is running, the active accessibility name will be the first one, DE325476. So DE325476 will be stored in this variable called child. Okay, and this child variable is generally a string variable. All right, so it is getting stored. After that, let me use an activity called select item. Okay, select item, you can either go for the modern activity, which has this kind of a small round symbol, or else you can also use the classic. Okay, so I am using a classic one. Many people ask me, how do I enable? So if you hit on this filter button, if you are using a modern design, then it will show you this option, show classic. If you are in a, your project is built in a classic design, then it will show you show modern. So you can click on that and utilize all the activities. All right. Now here I am using select item activity below the get attribute. Pretty simple. And here in the select item, what I'm going to do, I will, if you click on indicate on screen and let's indicate this particular drop down. So what happens by default? By default, it is selecting all the default options one by one. So I can select which option I want to click. I can let the activity know. But here I want to keep it dynamic, right? One by one, it has to click. So what I will do, I will delete this and I will give the child variable. So what would happen for the first time when the variable is running, the child variable is going to carry the first value, right? When the second time the loop will run, it will carry the second value. So automatically what would happen, the select item will get dynamic values inputted into this particular activity and it will click on all those specific items one by one, right? So this is a very simple way. So to see this, what you do in the select item activity, delay after, right, just write 2000 milliseconds, which is nothing but 2 seconds, so that it, after executing one by one, you will have little time to see them, right? You should be able to see them. So I have selected and given a 2000 milliseconds delay. So let's see that. So this is my site. So the very first activity it should select is automatically D31. So I'm keeping something else here. So it will automatically go and select the first one, second one, third one, so on. So let's run it and check that. So this will be very, very useful during your project. So you see the first one D3 has been selected. Now the second one got selected. Keep watching the screen. Now the third one, now the fourth one, right, and the fifth one. So this is how it is being selected one by one in a dynamic way. All right, I hope this particular set of activities would have helped you to understand how to do this kind of an activity, and this question, if it is asked, you can pretty well answer it. So thank you so much for watching it, and we'll come up with more interesting contents. Thank you so much. Please do subscribe to our channel and please do like all our contents that you're watching on our channel. Thank you. Bye bye.